What, you didn't think I was going to show up?
It's the Celtic Rumble.
Faster. What are the chances?
So, it's good to see you, man. The current Progress Heavyweight Champion.
Former Progress World Champion.
Right, well, that happens.
It's good to see the current CCW Heavyweight Champion.
Former, actually, too. So, you know. You in the Celtic Rumble tonight?
This is true, yes I am. Yourself?
Yeah, I'm in the Celtic Rumble tonight, too. So, looks like we've a match later on too, huh?
This is true, you and I.
Cool. Well, I'll leave you get ready, yeah?
Hey, Ricky. Hope you find peace tonight.
What does that mean? Find peace? I tell you what, I found peace long ago. I've been in CCW for 2 years now. How long have you been in CCW for?
Doesn't matter how long I've been here. My message is pure, my message is clear. I just hope you find peace, Ricky.
Your message is pure, your message is clear, huh? Okay. That's fine.
Peace go with you, Ricky.
Okay.
See you out there.
Sure. Bring your god with you.
Hey, come on! Fucking open down mechanism, hurry up!
Ah, well, seeing as you're here, may as well fill you in on a few facts. Fact number one, the Lone Wolf Lycan is the only man who has ever won the Celtic Rumble in CCW. And just like the last 2 years, this year, apart from the establishment, of course, the athletic bunch that they are, I ain't afraid of nobody in that goddamn match. There ain't one person in that match who I'm intimidated by or who I'm worried about. So you get one thing clear, whoever you are, the winner of tonight's Rumble, you ain't taking this bad boy away from me. This bad boy ain't going nowhere. We're not coming!
Jeez.
Oh, bro.
Oh, what's the story? Hey, were you like you? Running him out?
No!
About the Rumble?
No!
About the worried? About the not being worried?
That was Callahan!
Callahan. Yeah, well, listen, hold the hood up. Right, you need to listen, okay?
Yeah.
And keep listening, and keep listening, yeah. And keep listening. Because this is Ballymun Bruiser, yeah? This means I get that whenever I want. So be worried about the Rumble, because I might just win it. That means I'll get a shot, I'll get that belt, I'll go on, I'll get another belt, I'll get all the gold. Yeah, press your lift, press it, Wolf Boy, press it, woo! Whatever you want to say. Soon enough, buddy, that belt is mine.
Man, I'm hyped for the Celtic Rumble tonight. It's gonna be great. Got my number.
Yeah, good one. Man, I mean, like, I'm frustrated. I mean, why didn't they let me pick a number? I mean, like,
Max.
Yeah, I mean, like,
Max, raise your right arm. No, your right arm.
This is my right arm.
Okay, your other right arm.
Ah.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Sorry, bud.
Oh, so wait a minute. Let me get straight. So this means. This means I can't be in the Rumble tonight?
Yeah, I'm sorry, man, you really can't be.
Oh, thank God!
Wait, what?
Oh, I was trying to get out of this match for so long.
What?
I didn't want the rest of 29 other guys out there. I mean, the guys that are out there. Good luck, buddy.
But
yes! Yes!
Max, where are you going?
Because there's numbers and letters, letters and numbers. It's all jumbled up. It was never my fault. The matches were there, the petrol was there. Look, it was never my fault.
William wants to let you know that Bedlam Billy Lynch is number one in the Celtic Rumble tonight. Number one! It's going to be an interesting night and let's see what happens.
What was that?
Can we hear the choir roar?
Every company needs one, he's ours. Being accompanied by William, who I was actually informed earlier, is Billy's personal advisor. He's actually Austrian and was born in the 1940s.
He looks like a puppet to me.
No, it's his personal advisor.
Okay, you gotta wonder what kind of personal advice he's getting from his right hand. Looks like he's trying to protect the puppet from the crowd. This guy is clearly mentally deranged.
He's just talking things over with his advisor. I mean,
bit like Mr. Garrison or something.
Mr. Hyatt.
Bedlam Billy Lynch. Absolutely insane.
Well, you know what, Billy's definitely my pick to win this thing. It's his time to shine. It's time for the era of Bedlam.
Just trying to make Steve Wiley talk to this William.
Can you imagine? Can you imagine if Billy won this and got a chance at the title? It's won the title, then we'd have a little mini title for William. That'd be fantastic.
It is not unheard of in the first ever CCW Celtic Rumble. Lycan was first entrant and did go on to win it that year. Kenny Knox straight out of main stage wrestling. This guy is currently on a 4-0 in singles competitions. Rumbles are a lot different, but just going on those stats, the guy's obviously a very talented competitor.
Absolutely, and I mean, you know, he's straight out of main stage, but he has his work cut out for him.
Exactly,
against Billy here.
And not to mention the other 28 men that will be getting in the ring. But indeed, last time we would have seen Kenny Knox was in main stage against Electro, in which he defeated Electro.
Now Billy Lynch playing the psycho game. Getting the psychological advantage here. I think Billy Lynch now is getting ready to play. Wants to show Kenny Knox this is his house. As the two men get ready to square off.
Where's William in the corner? And the Celtic Rumble 2016 is underway. Beautiful block there by Kenny Knox.
Oh, break to the ice.
This match is well underway already. Both men going hell for leather at each other. Look at the lunacy of Bedlam Billy headbutting Kenny Knox into the side. Kenny Knox, of course, has the height advantage there, standing at 6'5".
So he's a tall man, but I mean, Billy Lynch has got the upper hand here already, and he's using everything. His man has thrown his head at him. Shades of the Junkyard Dog here.
He's just driving his head into the spine of Kenny Knox.
Really knocking himself out.
Yeah, but he doesn't matter. He doesn't mind.
It's mind over matter. He doesn't mind, and Kenny Knox don't matter.
Oh, big. Big forearms.
Oh, big elbow to the throat there.
Straight out of St. Anne's. Oh, and a chop there. Knocking Billy Bedlam back.
Going chop for chop here. More chops.
It's like our next contender is about to come out. Who's it gonna be?
Who have we got here?
Well, the two competitors still go at it, Kenny Knox and Billy Bedlam. Oh, Billy Bedlam around them big forms. It's none other than the Violent Gentleman, Frankie Phoenix. Another main stage wrestling superstar.
And he is ready to go, Frankie Phoenix here.
Very young brawler, only 25. Enjoys.
Oh! And I believe that was the Phoenix Rising.
Yeah, exactly. This young guy enjoys a nice whiskey and a good cigar. And like we see, stomping on wrestlers.
stomping a mud hole, and Kenny Knox now trying to get him over the top rope. Billy Lynch joining in here, the two men.
Working in tandem together now, Frankie Phoenix and Billy Bedlam. Of course, Phoenix only recently was unlucky in a number one contender match in main stage against Paul Tracy and the fabulous Nicky M. Oh, nice double suplex there. Frankie Phoenix and Billy Bedlam making quite a team together here, working over Kenny Knox.
Double teaming him now. That's smart. If these guys team up and they get Kenny Knox out in time, they can have the ring all to themselves.
Billy Bedlam trying to irritate the crowd here. Certainly no time for a respite here in this match. As soon as
that music sounds familiar, it's Idris
Nawabi. Beautiful going, absolutely head for leather here against Frankie Phoenix. And meanwhile, Kenny Knox works over Billy Bedlam. Oh, nobody home there. Frankie Phoenix getting out of the way. Just big slap there to Idris Nawabi. Meanwhile, Billy Bedlam is scrambling towards the ropes after being slammed by Kenny Knox.
Billy Bedlam, my man, he's my pick to win this thing, and by God, he will win.
It's too early to say now, only four competitors so far. We still have another 26 to go. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. This is the 30-man rumble. And the winner of which will be the number one contender for Lycan's Heavyweight Championship. Yet to see the dregs of the establishment pop up in this match, and you can mark my words, they will have some part to play in this match.
They will make their presence.
Beautiful counter there by Billy Lynch.
Idris Nawabi trying to pin there, but no, it doesn't work like that in this kind of match, ladies and gentlemen. Both feet have to go over, both feet have to touch the floor, and you must go over the top rope. It doesn't count if you go through or under the ropes.
Oh, what a chop there by Kenny Knox. It looks like Frankie Phoenix is good, but beautifully blocked by Idris Nawabi. That suplex blocked again.
Who's it gonna be?
Going at it there in the middle of the ring.
Who's it gonna be?
Oh my God, it's the Executioner!
No way!
We haven't seen this demon in the CCW in quite some time. This guy is the Punisher of the CCW, the Guilty Conscience. The Executioner, standing nearly 7 foot tall.
That is unbelievable.
Seems to be impervious to pain. One of the most dominant competitors in the history of the CCW.
He is absolutely huge.
He is straight in there. And look at Billy Bedlam biting down on Kenny Knox's ear there. Double clothesline there. Executioner throwing down a marker in this match already. He's got Idris Nawabi.
Both men.
Feeling.
Oh, both men gone over the top rope and they are eliminated.
Yeah, that is Idris Nawabi and Frankie Phoenix have been eliminated, the Violent Gentlemen. We still have Kenny Knox and Billy Bedlam in the ring.
Oh, Kenny Knox
has been eliminated. Now it's just the Executioner and Billy Lynch. Bedlam is out of the ring, but he didn't go over the top rope. He went down under the bottom, so he has not been eliminated. And the Executioner is going straight after him. Who is next, Kieran?
Ah, yes. Oh, yes.
This piece of crap. This is the first time we've seen him tonight.
The living legend. This is actually the second time we've seen him after he helped the establishment get over their victory in their tag team match earlier. The dog of a... Whoa, 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 what's this?
And Bingo straight out. Oh, here we go. Justice at last. Bingo has some unfinished business there.
This is ridiculous.
Marion Armstrong, Mr. Knockout.
This is assault.
I don't even know if Bingo...
He's eliminated him!
Just eliminate! Marion Armstrong!
What is...
And he just eliminated himself!
What is wrong with Bingo Balance?
He hates Marion Armstrong. That's what's wrong with him. He has got a serious grudge against him. These two men, look, security are having to break them up. This is getting very serious here.
Security breaking them up, do you know what I mean? Like, I don't like kiwi fruit, but I don't cost myself the championship chance for my hatred of it.
Two men there, and look, Marion Armstrong's going straight back to Bingo. And, oh, big takedown there, and I'd say they're brawling there at the side of the ring. Meanwhile, look what Executioner is doing to Billy Bedlam in the ring. He's hanging him up in the second rope, cutting off the air supply to Billy Bedlam's very mentally impaired brain, and he is crawling, crying out for William wherever he's gone. He was in the corner, can't see him anymore.
Pure hatred right here.
To our security guys having to remove Bingo Balance. That's how infuriated he is with Marion Armstrong. Mr. Knockout, Mr. Cop Out, he's run out here. There's been a serious match building between Bingo Balance.
Oh, we got up next.
For a long time. Billy Bedlam hanging on for dear life there as the Executioner is trying to get him over that top rope.
Everybody waiting in anticipation to see who's going to
make it. And all he's doing is shouting for William.
Oh, I believe maybe the reason why.
Oh, where is William? But what about Bingo Balance eliminating himself, going over the top rope?
That is the ultimate sacrifice right there. He truly hates Marion Armstrong. If he wants to risk his chance, risk a career-defining chance. And it's possible nobody's coming out there now because that was meant to be Bingo Balance.
Bingo's had the title before. Like, he's more concerned with absolutely decimating Marion Armstrong than winning the CCW Heavyweight Championship.
He can attack Marion Armstrong, you know, at any given chance. Why, oh why, would he choose the Celtic Rumble? It makes no sense, because not only is he costing himself the chance, but he's putting himself at further risk. What have we got next? Wildcat Tigre.
Again, another main stage wrestling.
One half of the Wildcats. The
former tag team, main stage tag team champions.
Taking it to the Executioner. Tigre,
look at this.
Executioner is reeling.
Luchador kind of style here.
Oh, Executioner not happy. Not happy at all.
Bedlam scrambling around the ring. Springboard moonsault off the second rope.
Executioner caught him.
Mid-air by the Executioner, but still managed to work out of it there beautifully. Tigre. And now Billy Bedlam is back to his feet and putting in a bit of punishment, getting a bit of revenge. Irish whip into the corner.
Two men going hard at the Executioner here.
Oh, Tigre, they're smashing his boot straight into the midsection of the Executioner.
The two men now taking on the Executioner.
Bedlam is staggering around the ring. He's been through so much already, being the number one entrant to the Rumble. Seen a lot of action so far, and he's doing very well to still be in it, in fairness. You know he's your pick for tonight.
Billy Bedlam is doing his best to hold in. Hold on here.
I would have had Bingo myself, but yeah, look at this. Clothesline's just not even knocking the fluff off of the Executioner. It is the spectacular Scotty Davis.
Nearly knocking a child onto the floor there. Scotty Davis perhaps a bit too intense.
Only 15 years of age. This guy is one of the youngest competitors ever in the CCW.
Oh, what athleticism he has going on.
Very excited to see this guy in action, though. He's been a freestyle wrestler since the age of 6. He's got 8 all-time freestyle wrestling championships, so that's good competitor he is at amateur level.
Executioner there is, he's taking a beating from everybody.
Background in Muay Thai.
Oh!
Oh my God! Nearly a standing shooting star press there.
That was phenomenal.
Oh, beautiful little senton there by Tigre. These two main stage guys are working well together and absolutely dominating the Executioner. It's been a serious comeback for him.
Oh, haven't seen him in the ring.
And now they're turning on each other. Tigre giving big chops there to Scotty.
Oh
my God. Tough son of a bitch.
Putting the boots.
Oh, dropping a big head there by the executioner onto the shoulder of Billy Bedlam.
Turning their sights back onto the executioner.
It's absolute pandemonium in the ring. Keeping up with it is Tigre and Scotty Davis. Go. Oh, a snapmare takeover of the executioner. And here we go, Tigre's tag partner.
The other half of the Wildcats.
Leopardo into a wheelbarrow, smashing him down on the executioner.
This is what the sidekicks would look like if they were anyway successful.
And look at Scotty Davis taking it to Billy Bedlam there in the corner. While the Wildcats work on the executioner, the beam taken out now. Size does matter when it comes to a rumble like this. And the executioner certainly has that on his side. Nice little exchanges going on here in the corner between Billy Bedlam and Scotty Davis. The spectacular driving a shoulder there into Billy Bedlam somewhere and following up with a big clothesline.
Executioner still taking one hell of a beating here, and you've got to give props to Billy Bedlam as well.
Oh, Bedlam nearly had eliminated Scott Davis there, but skins the cat. Celebrating a bit early. Oh, look at his beautiful kicks. The athleticism again, he has a background in Muay Thai. Does the spectacular Scotty Davis.
They're all trying to get the executioner over the top rope. He's a big man, he's not budging.
Who will be next?
He's back! The fan favourite is back!
Two addicts.
Oh, it's all going down now.
We have two of the biggest competitors in the history of the CCW in the ring at the same time, Executioner and Drew Onyx. Drew Onyx picks up Scotty Davis, takes a chop, zero effect. Well, the Wildcats are going to work on the Executioner in the corner. Billy Bedlam tries to get back to his feet.
Scotty Davis made a mistake.
Turning him inside out.
Oh, he paid for that mistake. Such a fatal flaw.
Meanwhile, the Wildcats still have the upper hand on the executioner, but not anymore.
Oh my God, Scotty Davis is lit up.
Billy Bedlam is scrambling around the ring, trying to get away from Drew Onyx.
Executioner just eliminated Scotty Davis.
Scotty Davis, the spectacular, has gone over the top. The Wildcats are tight. Oh, there's a bit of concern on their face, but still, gotta admire these guys that got balls.
Oh, Billy Bedlam
has been executed.
Billy Bedlam, my pick to win this thing.
He went high over the top rope there.
Well, you know what? From now, my money's on the executioner.
And look, there goes Leopardo. And there goes Tigre. It's just Executioner and Drew Onyx left in the ring. It looks like Tigre might have landed on Billy Bedlam there. Done even more damage to that already severely damaged brain.
When two titans meet, it means war.
This is like that immovable object, an unstoppable force.
God help any man who gets in the middle of these two guys. And who do we have?
Here we go, it's Devo from County Offaly. The perpetual underdog. We've seen him in a couple of rumbles.
He's trying to stand up, but it's not working for Devo.
Executioner and Drew Onyx was in a chop of the executioner. Oh,
no. Stupid move. Stupid move.
It looks like Executioner and Drew Onyx are fighting over who gets to eliminate Devo.
It's like two hungry men fighting over the last piece of chicken. Oh, Devo just got turned inside out.
That was not nice.
Oh, Devo can't see where he's going.
Oh my God.
Oh, what a nasty spill.
Hitting every branch on the way down there.
Oh, you know what I'm going to call Devo from now on? the punchline of CCW.
That must have been one of the shortest entrances in a Celtic Rumble, but still not breaking Roughshod's record at the 9 second mark.
9 seconds, it's correct. Now we finally get a see. Oh, oh my God, no!
And Onyx has eliminated the Executioner.
No way.
Cush can't believe what happened. What a comeback that they just cleared out between the two of them a minute ago, eliminating the Wildcats, Scotty Davis and Billy Bedlam. Shows his disdain for the crowd. Drew Onyx is the only man in the ring.
Executioner was robbed. Who have we got next? Oh, ho, ho. It is the man who saw retribution. Oh, they're squaring up. It's the man who saw retribution against the establishment earlier.
With that kendo stick. My God, the damage he did to DOC and Lee Carlan.
With the illegal assault.
Cry me a river.
Moshing like a maniac. Maybe he should just keep his eye on the prize for the time being. Keep his eye on Drew Onyx.
God, the crowd love Danny Butler here, don't they? Drew Onyx says,
oh. Show of respect from Drew Onyx.
What a warrior Drew Onyx is.
And Danny Butler has got to be reeling. He's got to be still a bit touchy and a bit sore from his match earlier.
The beast.
The crowd chanting for a beast. Shake of hands here, show of respect. Drew Onyx very sceptical.
Beautiful.
Nice show.
It's lovely to see that.
Display of showmanship.
He's giving a free shot.
Oh, what
might have regretted that.
Rocking him back and forth there.
Exactly. He knows how to throw a punch, the beast, Danny Butler. Drew Onyx is fighting out the hard way.
These two men going back and forth, you can hear the shots connecting. Test of strength here. Who is the tougher nut? I don't know. Drew Onyx is... He's powerful, but my God.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Two men shaking hands again. Both of them standing together, waiting to see who the next outer. And it is Mustafa Jordan again.
We saw this young man at the start of the show, and my God, he put on quite the display.
Absolutely great athlete. Good background in catch wrestling and a former basketballer. Big guy, young still.
Our younger fans crazy about Mustafa Jordan.
Great prospect for the future. All the way out of Brooklyn, NYC, bro. So we got a three-way brawl going on here.
Mustafa holding his own against these two gigantic men.
That's a clothesline. Danny Butler just stands there watching on.
He's taken him off his feet. And that is not an easy thing to do. It's not an easy thing to do to take Drew Onyx off his feet.
Jordan laying in now. Got to be nicely rested after his match earlier. At the very beginning of the show,
all men have to be exhausted. A lot of the men in this Rumble would have already competed tonight.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Yes! Oh, yes! That's what I'm talking about with DOC!
Of course.
Establishment in the house!
God forbid Lee Carlan would have the balls to come out and do something on his own. With his own.
You really feeling that injury.
And after Danny Butler unloaded with that kendo stick across the back of both DOC and Lee Carlan, they gotta be hurting. I hope they are. Mustafa, Danny Butler, and Drew Onyx wait in the ring. for the snide one, Lee Callan, and straight away, three men are wailing on Lee Callan.
This is disgraceful.
This is justice.
It's disgraceful.
While his little bitch, DOC, stands at ringside doing nothing.
Do you not think that they already got...
Mustafa's going up high.
Tonight by the disrespectful Danny Butler.
Big elbow straight on to the top on Lee Callan's head.
The incident last month we won't talk about where Ricky Combat shoved a cake in the face of Lee Callan and put DOC through a table.
That was disgraceful. Wasting that food. He should have put a glass into the face of Lee Callan.
That's vicious. That's vicious.
Just
Who's
desserts.
Up next?
Just desserts, bro.
Who have we got next?
Lee Callan, better hope.
Who's coming down now? All the men looking towards the ramp. DOC is in. Now we got two establishment in there.
Of course. Callan must have pulled a few strings there to get me another establishment member in here fast before I'm completely humiliated. Nice shot there. But, oh, he's getting a bit of offense in there.
Oh.
Against Drew Onyx. But the beast Danny Butler turning DOC inside out and with a big clothesline there. Let's see, Mustafa Jordan is just waiting.
Oh, Lee hanging on. Clinging to the bottom rope, the genius of Lee Callan
there. He didn't touch the ground.
DOC getting fended off there. Oh, no.
He is in big trouble. Big,
that body
big
is worth
trouble.
A lot of money. Don't you dare damage it. Oh, no!
DOC screaming in agony. The beast Danny Butler ain't done yet. Oh, oh. Across the back for good luck. But Lee Callan starts teeing off against Mustafa Jordan in the corner.
A DOC cleverly hanging on there.
Just managed to stay in.
Drew Onyx turns around and sees him. Finally, Danny Butler doing something sensible. We got next.
The size of this guy, Gunter
Isaac.
Oh
my God, Gunter Isaac.
What?
Look at the face of Mustafa Jordan, he can't believe it.
Fighting out of Dublin. Gunter Isaac, he's very young, only 17. But God, is this guy big. 6'6", 265 pounds.
He is a behemoth of a man. He is taking it to every single one of them.
This guy's been on the scene since he was 15. He's mainly concentrated his work around main stage in Dublin. Oh, nice by the beast Danny Butler. Straight takes out the knee. Oh, and focusing again on a beautiful.
DOC now, Lee crawling back into the ring. DOC picking apart Mustafa Jordan there.
Beautiful
Lee about
punishment.
To join him. The establishment taking hold of what is rightfully theirs.
Mustafa getting a bit of an upper hand here on Mustafa Jordan, but Drew Onyx comes to spoil that spot, that party.
Gunter Jordan is thinking something up.
Getting the beast chance going. Tell you, Danny Butler mightn't be a bad outside bet here for tonight as well. Certainly doing very well tonight. And now, look, the establishment are just having shots rain out of the ball.
Two big men. Oh, three big men going at it. Gunter Isaac practicing indiscriminate violence. Oh, Mustafa nearly going over the top rope. Who's in next? Who we got? Bruiser! Bruiser in the house.
Oh my God.
What in the name of all that's good and holy? A stop sign. Kendo stick. Walking stick. That's trash can lid. Oh my goodness.
Golf clubs.
Metal a dinner
trays. And a steel bin. I tell you, there's a lot of people who will need those walking sticks come the end of the night. Oh, already. God, Gunther Isaac, and taken out Lika Alan, Mustafa Jordan, and again on Gunther Isaac.
Johnny Butler wearing it off the head of
Dio. Mustafa Jordan has been eliminated by the
Oh, Gunther Isaac is gone.
Drop straight over. Gunther Isaac is out. Look at the beast Danny Butler driving that. God, these weapons have certainly shaken things up here. Kendo stick now about to be, smashed across the back of Lee Cahalan. My God, these competitors are coming in thick and fast.
What in the name of God? No. I told you, that body and that face are worth a lot of money. Don't you dare damage it.
Uh-oh. Oh, that has nearly knocked DOC clean out. Ricky Combat. Definitely in with a big chance. And look at the punishment. It's a mess in that ring.
Starting off with a weapon, Ricky Combat, like a coward, afraid to fight with his hands.
Combat smashing that.
Bruiser leaving the ring there moments early.
Just letting the ref know that he was going out under the bottom rope.
Bruiser, oh my God, no. Bruiser has got a table.
And Beast. Oh, Danny the Beast has nearly got Lee Gallan, but he's been eliminated himself by the sneakiness of DOC.
DOC went out under the second rope, doesn't count.
Not at all. Ricky Combat driving his foot down onto the top and spine of DOC.
What in the name of God is Bruiser doing?
Drew Onyx as well is just absolutely smashing the spine of Lee Gallan. Look at this. The weight of Drew Onyx straight down on the back of Lee Gallan. And meanwhile, Ricky Combat has almost got DOC eliminated here. But DOC is just fighting back, dropping elbows down.
Oh,
no blow there by
Bruiser joking around.
Oh.
And that's got to leave his bell ringing. Oh, with the walking stick. That's fraud. He doesn't need that walking stick.
Oh, my God. And Lee Gallan is going to town with that metal tray. God, I'm out of breath.
Oh, the Red Menace.
Red Menace. Never seen this guy in a match in CCW before. Bit of a clown. I've only seen him doing the raffle. Who the hell is this
Coming
guy?
Coming out to Blue Suede Shoes, the Red Menace.
We'll see if this guy is any good now once he gets in. Straight away by Ricky Combat.
3 seconds.
That's a new record.
That is a new record. The Red Menace has smashed the old record of Roughshaw being eliminated in 9 seconds.
I'm sure Roughshaw would be delighted with that record being broken.
Well, I never. He wasn't
Red
ready.
Red Menace, what a poor showing. Wait, it looks like Bruiser's trying to appeal to everyone. Let's concentrate on the big guy first, and then we can turn on each other. But they do need to team together if they are going to eliminate Drew Onyx size. Look at the effort it takes, Stephen. Is this it for Drew Onyx? Is this it?
Oh, he's hanging on, he's hanging on. Bruiser with a
baseball
drop kick.
Slide.
Oh. And that is it for...
Drew Onyx has been eliminated.
Oh, Lee is... No. Ooh. Come on, Lee, you can do it. You can stay in, buddy. Come on.
Go on, Ricky. So we're just left with the establishment, and we've got Ricky Combat and Bruiser. That's the sidekicks music. And here he is, Ace Andrews, fresh from the raffle.
Taking a shot to the gut.
Didn't make the greatest entrance there. Lee Gallan got the upper hand immediately. Look at DOC here in the corner. He's actually taking it to Ballymun Bruiser, but Ricky Combat in there.
Oh, DDT. Bruiser swinging those sticks around wildly like a madman.
The martial art of swinging walking sticks.
I wouldn't really consider that a martial art, it's more like a Ballymun art. Oh, he's queuing him up.
Art nonetheless.
Oh.
There goes Ace Andrews.
Oh.
There goes Cahalan.
No respect.
DLC driving his knee straight into the neck of Ricky Combat. Just, oh, but he was hit by a low blow by Bruiser there to the rescue.
Lewis Wood in next. One half of the tag team, the Wood Brothers.
Of course, these guys have been at CCW for years now. Great competitors. Out of the Fight Factory. In Bray County Wicklow, one half with his brother Larkin.
Stomping away on Ricky Combat, taking it to him. Trying to make a name for himself really here, going straight after Ricky Combat.
Exactly, almost has an elimination straight off the bat, and DLC going to help, but Ricky Combat turns the tables. Oh, it takes a lot more than that to eliminate a man of Ricky Combat stature. Lee Gallan is absolutely exhausted. He is, look at this, again, out of the ring, typical establishment.
Playing it smart, they can't be eliminated if they're already on the outside.
You look up cowardly in the dictionary, there's a picture of Lee Gallan right
there. Where did he get a golf club out of?
That came in Bruiser's.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
This is the new,
that is
vicious side of Ricky Combat.
That. Oh. Has he no respect for a man's genitalia?
Oh, Ace Andrews in big trouble. Oh,
did you ever think you'd see the day Ricky Combat and the establishment working side by side?
No, I never did think it. And if there is any alliance, believe me, it'll be very temporary.
Here he comes.
There we go. El Jabrido, we saw him for about 4 seconds in a match against Bruiser earlier.
Oh, watch out behind you, Jabrido. Bruiser is right there.
Looks like El Jabrido's trying to get Ricky Combat up over. He would be going through that table if he actually went over. Get beautiful moonsault there by Larkin Wood.
Oh, there goes Larkin.
Lewis Wood, should I say, sorry.
Oh, Lewis, my apologies. Lewis has been eliminated.
Oh, now Lee Gallan, the establishment of DOC and Lee Gallan are absolutely... Oh, a beautiful counter there by Ballymun Bruiser. Just when you think he's down, he comes back straight back up. And El Jabrido has been eliminated by Ricky Combat.
Not a great night for El Jabrido today. Back to County Wexford, or County Mexico.
El Dungarvan?
Yes, El Dungarvan, County Mexico.
Oh, what an uppercut there from Bruiser, knocking DOC straight onto his back. Ace Andrews has been eliminated. And here comes the other half of the Woods Brothers tag teams, Larkin Wood. Oh, this guy's certainly a powerhouse.
Not as agile as his brother, but
my certainly God, stronger, strong. Yeah. I mean, this guy hits so hard. This could be it for DOC.
No, don't doubt the DOC yet.
He just managed to stay in. Lee Gallan is unconscious on his feet. Not even on his feet anymore. Hung up in the second rope. Ricky Combat taking advantage, driving the knee straight into the spine.
DOC is taking a fair beat.
Looks like an Olympic slam there from Bruiser. No one left nearly for Bruiser. Bruiser saying he's sorry to someone. Not sure who. It certainly isn't to someone in the ring. Looks like he's enjoying meeting out this punishment.
Oh. I sincerely hope somebody along the lines of Lorcan Wood definitely wins this, because I mean, I don't see him being any threat at all to Lycan. In fact, I don't see any man in that ring being a threat to Lycan. I wonder what would happen if Lee Cahalan won this, or DOC.
DOC would be told to lie down to Lycan.
And he would do it.
It could be very interesting if Lee Cahalan did go on. And straight out of Swiss Pro Wrestling, it's Kurt Simmons. It's been a while since we've seen him in CCW.
And Kurt Simmons is certainly looking the part. He is in top form here tonight.
Great shape, yeah. I'd be very interested to see what he can take, or what he can bring to this rumble.
Straight over to Lorcan Wood.
Kurt Simmons straight on to Lorcan Wood. While Lee and Bruiser go toe-to-toe, Ricky Combat's about to... Oh, look, Jesus.
Look at
he
the
just welts. Smashed DOC into the turnbuckle.
Look at the welts on the side of DOC there. He's taking a beating tonight.
Good. He deserves it.
Ah, no. He deserves to win this. He's put up with so much. Such courage. Such tenacity. Such bravery.
Oh, look at Bruiser lulling Kurt Simmons into a fall sense of security. Asking him was all right. And then nailing with a big chop. But anyway, meanwhile, Ricky Combat...
Nearly eliminated. Go on, Lorcan, knock him over.
Lorcan, by Lorcan Woods. Oh, beautifully hung up in the top rope there by Ricky Combat. Oh, the punishment that DOC has deservedly taken. Smashed into the ring post there again. What? A spank on the arse from Ballymun Bruiser. And Kurt Simmons is trying to...
Now it's a party.
Another establishment member. Here he is again from the Free State of South Africa. It's Jack Vice.
Now it's a party. The big man's in. The enforcer of the establishment. And Jack Vice and DOC there.
That makes entrant 26. There's only four more men to enter this rumble. This is a good time to be making an entrance. You have a good opportunity for victory here. What the other competitors in the ring need to do now is band together and work against the establishment.
Oh no.
But God knows they will be working together.
There is no banding together against the establishment.
The Wood has nearly got Lee Cahalan, but it was stopped by a big headbutt by Jack Vice.
You live by our rule. That is the motto, and that is the way.
Well, a lot of us refuse to live by our look at it. Embrace here by Lee Cahalan, and to the rescue, Jack Vice. DOC is still somehow there now, working with Kurt Simmons. Working, what should I say? More like beating the crap out of Kurt Simmons. Big uppercuts. And Bruiser had just absolutely annihilated Lee Cahalan. Oh, and a poke to the eyes of DOC.
Kurt Simmons was hanging on there now, but he's
rescued.
Back in. Rescued himself.
Matt Schuyler, definitely the lightest and shortest in the ring, but coming at this position when so many other competitors are exhausted, look at this, like Lee Cahalan. He certainly puts him at an advantage. Oh, now as he steps up to DOC and starts unloading on him.
Absolutely, and we saw Matt Schuyler take his place in CCW when he debuted.
My God.
When he debuted at Project Mayhem, landing a beautiful,
look
beautiful
at the chops
50.
From Bruiser to Matt Schuyler. Oh, my God.
Oh, that is vicious.
Destruction in live in color. And now he's been choked up by the bully. Jack Vice, Lorcan Wood has been eliminated. Looked like Lee Cahalan got the elimination there, Lorcan Wood. DOC. DOC's been eliminated as well.
Oh my.
Security are having to escort.
Look at Matt Schuyler, and he's gone.
Is straight out over the top road. Military press from Bruiser. Good chance of winning this. He's doing very well.
We are down one establishment member, and that is not good. The slaps up.
Number 28, who's it going to be? Star champ Omega is here, and he's been called on by Jack Weiss. He wants a bit of him. Jack Weiss hung up in the top rope.
Oh,
and
Super no! Over. On top of everybody.
And Jack Weiss has been eliminated.
This is the worst possible situation.
Oh, what a super kick.
This young punk came in and just took out one member of the establishment. Does he not know who he's dealing with?
There is only one member left, and it is King Weasel himself. Lee Galan is the only surviving member of the establishment still in this rumble. Bruiser's in a spot of bother as Galan goes toe-to-toe with Omega. Combat gathers himself in the corner. Oh, my
God. What a boot to the face.
What a super kick. And now Bruiser and Combat get involved once again.
What are they planning on doing? Oh! And Omega and Bruiser chopping each other with smiles on their faces.
Love competing with each other. Galan was put over the top rope, but still hanging on in there. The second to last. And he's back.
Here he is again, the Pastor William Eber.
Former Progress Wrestling champ.
He's blessing. Blessed. He's giving him the last rites on the way to the ring. I don't believe this.
Blessing Kurt Simmons.
He is blessing bodies as he goes.
Everyone's lining up to have a chop off Matt Schuyler. Poor kid. Rocky Wood is still arguing.
He wants to be let back in.
Matt Schuyler's chest. Yeah. It is glowing red. And what a super kick there to the back of Bruiser's head as Pastor William Eber makes his entrance. We have only one competitor left. Look at Jack Weiss. After being super kicked over the top rope by Omega and eliminated. And it's Ricky Combat is going to be the first one who's going to step up to Pastor William Eber. While Omega and Lee Galan wrestle on the other side of the ring. Oh my God, a dropkick went to the throat of Ricky Combat by the Pastor.
And of course, Pastor William Eber very successful over Ricky Combat earlier on tonight.
And now look at Omega driving the shoulder into Galan. Right there in the corner of the ring. Oh, and as soon as you turn back around, Bruiser's there to hit you with an uppercut.
Oh, brutal.
No one chops like Bruiser chops.
Look at Lee Callahan. That's very smart. He's strangling Omega from behind with the wrist tape.
Oh, shining wizard.
Number 30
there.
Up next. Who's our last entrant?
Who is the last member? Vic Viper.
Vic Viper, the Snake Man himself, the legend, absolute living legend of Irish wrestling. This man has been on the circuit for so many years.
It's been 3 years since we've seen him in the CCW. This guy had many a title fight with the CCW. Again, it is our fourth birthday. He was there right at the start. Oh! Galan's been blown off the top rope.
Through the table! Somebody check on him! For the love of God, get him to a hospital!
And Vic Viper is going to work here. All the way
to Snake Mountain. Hickey, give him out to mouth!
Oh, and Omega's been eliminated, the All-Star champ, after beautifully eliminating Lee. And we are now down to four. 30 men enter, 4 men left.
Lee Callahan is covered in splinters. Somebody, for the love of God, check on him. But our top story now, Vic Viper has returned to CCW and he is out for blood and spitting venom.
What a comeback it would be if he was to go straight in as the number one contender by winning the Celtic Rumble.
And I have no doubt.
Something to behold.
Vic Viper and is my new pick to win this, and indeed he will.
It looks like he's hand-picked Ricky Combat here to be the recipient of this punishment.
What better way to do it?
Oh. Stomping down a Ricky Combat while Bruiser still taking the piss now out of Ever. Blessing him, dropping the knee right.
Dropping him.
Dropping
flat.
Right into the groin area of the pastor.
This is an outstanding comeback.
Oh.
Vic Viper. It is an absolute privilege to call one of his matches.
Look at this, two behemoths here.
Two
Bruiser
men
versus Vic Viper.
Two men who know each other so well. Both legends of the
Irish.
Bruiser
going to get the elimination here? No, just didn't mean to get manage to get it done. He's got to be feeling.
Oh, Bruiser is gone. Bruiser's gone.
I was just about to say, he's probably feeling a bit of fatigue now. He's been in the ring so long in this rumble.
He's ushering the pastor. Can he convince him?
Hold him, oh. Vic Viper, and Pastor William Ever follows up. Nailing.
And Vic Viper and William Ever, if they can throw Ricky Combat, because you got to believe Ricky Combat should be one of the favourites to win this. I hate to say it, I really do hate to say it, but he could be one of the favourites to win.
But definitely deserving. Seeing Ricky Combat is a former championship choice winner as well. Ooh, Vic Viper is certainly taking no stick from the Cork audience here. Oh, Ricky Combat ducks. And Vic Viper follows through and absolutely nails Pastor William Ever in the head with a clothesline. The crowd just chanting Ricky's name, willing him to keep going. Anything left in the tank, he has given it his all so far tonight. And don't forget, he already had a huge match with the Pastor William Ever.
Come on, Vic. The man is Vic Viper, the living legend of Irish wrestling, is my pick to win this.
Certainly has a very good chance now. He's the last man in. Although William Ever, I'd say, like, if you were to, odds would be stacked heavily in Vic Viper and William Ever's favour. Well, Ricky Combat has got to be the underdog at this stage, because the fact is he must be so exhausted from the length of time he's been in this rumble.
Vic Viper doesn't really care for the religious properties of William Ever.
Don't think many people do. Oh, look, we can see Kurt Simmons getting a blessing. Ricky Combat can barely stand. And what a clothesline there from Pastor William Ever on Vic Viper. The living legend of Irish wrestling, as you said yourself.
I don't know why William Ever is just staring at Ricky Combat. He's got the chance to take him out, and he's going for it. Oh, he's got him up for the GTS.
Oh, and he's hit it again.
Oh, Ever's reeling. Oh, Ever is gone.
That is the end of William Ever. And now it is just Vic Viper and Ricky Combat. It probably won't be for too long. It looks like Vic Viper is going to dispose of Ricky with no delay. Oh my God, he could just kick the head clean off him here. Ricky, move.
Oh,
big punt.
I don't think he heard you, Tom. He was too late.
I don't think he'd be here. Look at it. Oh,
you can't sleep on a guy like Vic Viper. You can't sleep on him. He will get you.
Oh, what a vicious leg drop. Ricky looks like he doesn't know which way from Tuesday.
I am so excited to see Vic Viper back in action again. It's been a long time, too long.
Oh, Vic Viper is just punishing Ricky. Looks like he wants to inflict a bit of pain here before eliminating Ricky Combat and then going on. I mean, what a great match it would be if it was Vic Viper versus Lycan Fire, the title.
Fighting at a Snake Mountain.
Snap. Oh, it looks like he's got.
Oh, is he going for it? Oh, he was attempting He's attempting the snake bite or the venom's kiss, rather.
And Vic Viper celebrating, but has Ricky's feet touched the ground?
No, I believe they haven't.
He's skinning the card, he's still here. Oh, oh. Ricky is. Ricky means business.
Come on, Vic, fight back.
Pushing him further. Come on, Ricky.
You can do it, Vic. Oh, reverse. Ducks the clothesline.
And again, grabs a wrist lock.
No!
Up into the GTS. No. Oh,
oh, he got him, he got him. He's reeling. Come on, Vic, wake up!
And a clothesline. No. You're going to need more momentum. Vic's a big guy. And Vic Viper has been eliminated. And Ricky Gombat is the winner of the 2016 Celtic Rumble. Again, another number one contendership shot for Ricky Gombat.
That's not fair. He's had enough chances. Somebody replay the tape.
As long as you keep earning those shots.
Somebody
replay
the tape. I don't think Vic Viper's feet are still hitting the floor.
What a summer brawl we've had this year. Ricky Gombat is the winner of the 2016 Celtic Rumble, and now is number one contender for the heavyweight championship.
Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen.
Vic Viper looks very displeased.
Vic Viper was so close.
Not happy about Ricky Gombat. Celebrates on. His body must be bruised and battered after that ordeal in the Celtic Rumble.
So close.
Unbelievable stuff. Just brilliantly managed to get it done right at the end. Clotheslining Vic Viper over the top rope and out of the ring.
Ricky Gombat outlasting 29 other men, entering at number 19. What a ferocious battle. What a ferocious battle indeed, Tom.
Absolutely.
What a summer
crazy
brawl.
What a summer brawl and what a Celtic Rumble. You can catch us all our live shows on WrestleDope on YouTube. Check us out on Facebook. Celtic Championship Wrestling. Pleasure to be with you, Kieran.
You
not
too,
like
Tom.
That sounded a bit weird. But anyway, thanks for joining us. Check out all our shows on WrestleDope.com.